to talk with you about how do you be more intentional and purposeful about making a consistent profit in your business. And I'm going to share with you some key ways that you can start to evaluate and look at your business so that you can start to see and have a plan for how do you be more purposeful and intentional. And you know, what I see a lot of times is that as business owners, we work super hard and we really want to have everything turn out. We're doing everything that we think that we need to do, but there's not a clear strategy or a plan about if I do these things specifically, that's really going to help me make more profit, or that's going to help me be more effective with my team, or that's going to help me be more effective in terms of project management or production, you know, the production side of my business, or even maybe it's finance, right? So the question becomes either we just worry about it. We have it spinning around in our head all the time, and we think about it, and it gets more attention when it rises to the level of being urgent or the latest emergency or problem. Or the other side of it is we have this long list of things that we are wanting to do in our business, but we never seem to have the time to do. And one of the things that I notice is that when we can keep things down to the most simple and fundamental elements that are really going to give us the most leverage to be able to make a change, we have a much greater likelihood of having that happen. And I actually tell people that you should have no more than 3 key initiatives in 1 year. Like, these are your big, hairy, audacious goals for the year that are not, you know, you're going to do a lot of things, you're going to take on a lot of projects. But one of the things I say is, if you have just 3 things and you get your team aligned to those 3 things, you have a much greater likelihood of actually having it turn out. And I've seen this repeatedly in the work that I've done with clients. So what I want to talk about today is, how do you assess your business and look at all the different elements and decide and choose which are the ones that are most important that are going to let you take control of where you're driving your business to? And I want to talk, I'm going to share my screen here in a second, and I'm going to talk about how do you evaluate each part of your business, and then I'm going to talk about where are the risks in your business of losing profitability and losing money that would maybe let you determine where are your priorities, where are those 3 most important things that you want to focus on. So I'm going to jump in here now and I'm going to show my screen and we will get started. So this is the profit cycle. And the profit cycle is where profits are made and lost in your business. And the first part, and so here's the thing, there's different elements to your business, right? There is marketing. So if you were opening your business today and you were going to go out and sell your services for the first time, you would have to be doing business development and marketing. You'd have to let people know who you are, what sets you apart from the competition, what it is that is your unique selling proposition, and what's the problem that you solve for people. Your being able to do that consistently or not is really what's the thing that makes the phone ring. So doing consistent marketing creates an opportunity for you to be able to make an offer. So marketing is a really essential and critical thing for businesses to do. And I'll tell you a story. In late 2008, early 2009, when we were heading into that last big recession, I started getting a lot of phone calls from people who were like, oh my gosh, like work's drying up and I don't know what to do. And I've got my, you know, crew and I need to keep my business going and I need some help making sure to, you know, work on my profitability. And one of my first questions to people was always, so tell me what you're doing for marketing. And often I would get the answer, I'm answering the phone. And in an economy, you know, 5, 6, and 7 were really strong economies in construction was booming. And What I noticed was that people had been in this cycle of being just responsive to what shows up as opposed to being actively connecting with people. So in business development and marketing, that's not something that you do once. It's something that you do consistently. And you do it when you're busy so that you don't have these cycles of up and down, right? When everybody who's been in business has experienced it at some point or another, right? Where there's these cycles of I market, I get super busy, I stop marketing because I'm too busy to market, and then business starts to slow down, and then I've got the downslide, and then I start to market, and business goes up, right? So the key here is find some things that you should be doing and you want to be doing that are going to leverage your being able to generate more work. And when I say leverage, I mean not just I'm doing like the bullet approach, right? You want to be strategic in what you're doing in your marketing and business development, that you're getting exposure to your ideal client and that you're looking for ways to connect to those people who are great referral sources for you. So one of the ways that's super low-hanging fruit is connecting with your existing customers and reaching out to them consistently. So that's the first piece and the first leg of the profit cycle and making a consistent profit in your business and looking at how do I make a shift in that in this next year. So then the second place where profits are made and lost in a business is in estimating and proposals. So this is the stage where you're making an offer, but where are profits made and lost here? This is really the beginning of short of you didn't make the phone ring, right? So if there's no revenue, then you're not going to have profitability. But if you've done all the marketing, then the question comes, you get into estimating and doing proposals. There are certain key elements that drive the profitability of your business when you get to this stage. That has to do with things like knowing your pricing, being really clear that you have prices that are commensurate with what it really costs you. Interestingly enough, I had talked to a headhunter not long ago who told me that the cost of labor has gone up 20% in the last 2 years. Just gross wages has gone up 20%. And then I listened to a podcast the other day, and this woman was talking about the tariffs that are going on with China right now and how that increased of cost has been about 25%, that increase in cost has gone directly to you, the contractor or interior designer, and thus to your customer. So if you're not increasing those costs when they're coming to you, you're giving away your profits right off the bat in the estimating stage. The other key place where I see that profits get made and lost at estimating is when people don't have a goal for how much gross profit margin you want to be making. So this is where you start to be super intentional about what's the profit margin that I want to make, because contractors live and die by gross profit margin. And so making sure that you have the right markup in order to give you your desired gross profit margin is critical to being able to make a consistent profit. And this is where your profits and your gross profit margin begins, really starts. So one of the things I would recommend is make sure that you have a goal when you're estimating for what you want your gross profit margin to be. And the second recommendation I would have is make sure to check your labor rate table and be clear that you have the most up-to-date rates for all of the positions in your company. And I recommend you use the highest paid position in your estimating, when you're estimating a particular position to do work, whether that's a laborer, foreman, carpenter, whatever. And then make sure that it includes all of the burden, right? So the other thing I've noticed in the last couple of years is a lot of people are paying out a lot more in benefits. You know, there's more in health insurance and life insurance and dental and 401k and more benefits that you're giving your employees in order to make it a more attractive place to work. You want to make sure that all of those costs are included when you look at what's it really costing you and when you're estimating about what the real cost of that employee is. So that's the second place where profits begin to get made and lost, is in your estimating, having accurate pricing for what it really costs you, and then making sure that you have enough markup to cover your overhead and make a profit. So having a goal for your gross profit margin. The third place where profits are made and lost is in sales. Now, I have sales as a separate step in here because a lot of times people link together estimating and they go, well, that's bidding and that's sales. And I look at it completely differently. I look at that there's a whole sales process that begins from the moment the phone rings until that contract is signed. And so having an intentional process or purpose around that, what I have seen and found is that people make a much more consistent, have a higher close rate. They have more consistent sales and more consistent closes when they're intentional about their sales process. So that there's a process for when the phone rings that people go through a certain number of questions and steps that identify if it's a right fit and you're a right fit, if they're a right fit for you too. And then that there are certain steps about how we manage that relationship through the, we go to do the site visit. Do we have a checklist for questions that we ask? Do we leave them a packet of information about our business that has testimonials from happy clients and tells them about our company and our values and what they can count on from us, right? That when the proposal is done, that we present it in person or at the very least via Zoom, that we're doing something that we're connecting with people and we're not just emailing it. And then that we also get agreement about when we're following up. And that those are all steps that go into having a good sales process so that you have more control over how many of those projects that you actually get. And honestly, people just need attention too. And if you're just not paying attention, then what you're going to find is that you're not building know, like, and trust with people. And that's really what having a good sales process is about, is building know, like, and trust. And when you do, you're going to stand out from the competition. So obviously, if you sell more, you're going to have more profits. So this is another key way where profits are made and lost in your business. The other thing I would just recommend is that you track what your close rate is so that you can start to see how effective you are in that area. But at the very least, have a sales process and something, again, that you're just being intentional about. The next place where profits are made and lost is in the production side of things. So one of the things that I've seen, I have a client who, when we first started working together, their profitability was very low. And when we started to evaluate all the different parts of their business, what we saw was they had increased in their volume quite a bit in sales, but their gross profit margin was declining. And when we went and looked at where some of the issues were, and we went through the process of evaluating each part of their business as we're doing here, and I'm going to recommend that you do for your business, we determined, what we figured out was one of the things that was missing is that handoff process from estimating and sales to production, that putting in a process whereby they got really clear with the production team about how many hours do you have and what's the what's included, what's not included, what are the inclusions, you know, not inclusions, what are some key things that you need to know about the family, the house, the client that you want to use to make sure the job goes smoothly. So what they implemented was a much more thorough process when they were estimating of documenting for the production team, not just for the customer, but for the production team about here's what's included, here's what's not, here's what my thinking was when I did each piece of this. And then they went through it with a production team at the beginning of the job. And then they went through it with a production team again a few weeks later. And when they started to do that, what they found is the production team was able to finish projects more on time and to meet the number of hours that were estimated in the project in the first place. So they found that they were able to retain and keep their margin much more regularly on projects because they were much more intentional about that handoff process. So one of the key things with production is making sure that your production team just gets started on the right foot and doing that handoff process to them. One of the other things that's really key on the production side is, because here's what happens in production oftentimes. Somebody gets the set of plans, gets the scope of work, and then you got your foreman or superintendent who just goes off and starts working at it. And maybe there's a schedule, maybe there's not, but what they do is they get very focused on the work. And oftentimes what I see is that there's a lack of clarity about where I'm heading or planning in advance for heading. I had a client who he used to be the fireman in his business because his foremen were constantly calling him all the time about, well, the subcontractor didn't show up, or, you know, Steve didn't show up for the job today, or I don't have the right materials for the job. And the project manager was constantly just putting out fires for all these projects. And what we did is we implemented something called a 2-week look ahead. So looking ahead at what were the sub needs, what were the material needs, what's the labor needs, what are issues that need to get addressed with the client, and just projecting out for the next 2 weeks. And he started to do that with his team every week, where he and his foreman sat down and they started planning. And what he found is that they started having way more control over what was happening on their jobs. They were able to have a greater sense of control and confidence in what they were doing, and they had more clarity about how to make that job actually turn out. So that process of doing those 2-week look aheads really empowered them to have more control. And ultimately the project manager stopped being the firefighter and was able to focus on more important things like looking ahead on the project, managing the client relationship, and managing change orders and so on. And we'll talk about project management in a second. But that's another second key piece there, is on the production side, having a consistent process for doing 2-week look aheads can make all the difference in the world. And that's one of the key ways to have profits not be lost and to be able to make a consistent profit in your business. So let's talk about the next piece, which is accounting. Now, a lot of times people think accounting is just an expense and that it really doesn't contribute to the profitability of your business, but nothing could be further from the truth. So having an accounting department that has a regular schedule of when things get input into the system and into the software and when job costing happens. So payroll is kind of a given, right? Nobody can ever skip payroll, nor do they, right? Because that's a much bigger problem, right? But then there's accounts payable and vendor payments and invoices for materials or subcontractors. And then there's things like billings. And what I have found is that accounting, making sure that they have a schedule to get that information into the system quickly, is really the key to you being able to, as an organization, have the kind of feedback that you need, which is the next piece of what we're going to talk about here, is reporting, right? So accounting is really a central piece of making sure that you're getting information and feedback in a timely manner, so that things like production, one of the things about production that's important is that they're looking at labor hours burned. Production doesn't, your field people don't operate in dollars, really, right? They operate in people, and I'm talking about foremen, your laborers, carpenters, right? They operate from the place of, I have so many people, I have so many hours, and giving them feedback about where they stand on a regular and timely basis is really critical for their ability to keep projects on time and on budget. So that really requires that information and a good control system in accounting. So one of the things that you might want to do in accounting, and I recommend that people do this, is to put in an accounting calendar in place, so that that accounting calendar can help you plan out when and where and how things are going to happen, particularly the when, so that you and the accounting team get on the same page about that. One of the other key things about accounting I'll just throw in here is that making sure that you have the appropriate liability and that they're minimizing your risk and liability. So it's another place to look, because not minimizing it is going to affect your profitability as well. So the next piece on here, as they say, is reporting, and having a system whereby you're looking at your feedback on a regular basis, both on projects and for your company, is critically important. And what does that mean? Well, in terms of projects, it means looking at your job profitability reports on completed jobs on a regular basis, on, as I said, on hours, looking at hours burned against the budget, looking at your financial statements, your profit and loss, your balance sheet every month. And one of the things I recommend that you do is you have, if you want to be intentional about making a greater profit in your business, is to put an operating budget in place. Because when you have an operating budget, it's just like a budget for a project, right? Where you say, I'm going to spend a certain amount of money, I'm going to make a certain amount of money, and then you manage against that through the project. And you're constantly looking at where am I compared to where I said I wanted to be. So that ability to be able to do that same thing in your business allows you to be more purposeful, intentional about your profits and to be able to make a more consistent profit. And I got to tell you, I've been doing this with clients for all the years that I've been in business and having them do operating budgets every year, and not the kind that are just numbers on a piece of paper that you ignore, but operating budgets that are really based on a thought out plan about what am I going to do this year? Just like you would do a thought out plan for doing a budget for a project. It's no different. And so you already have this skill to do this. And as you know, a budget on a project is not constraining. A budget on a project gives you the ability to control and manage a result. And the same thing is true for your business. So when you look at reports every month, I also encourage you that you look at your budget versus actual to see how you're doing. Because numbers, one of the things I say is that numbers in them by themselves don't mean anything. They mean something in relationship to something else. So numbers in and by themselves don't mean anything. They mean something in relationship to something else. So what's the something else? The something else is the goals that I set, and the something else is how have I done in the past. Those are two really great ways to be able to look at how are you doing in your business and am I improving or am I not improving? So the next key place where profits are made and lost in your business is in project management. Now, obviously, so project management and what the world of construction and contracting is all about is on time, on budget, as promised. So when you have the ability to be able to get feedback that lets you manage for on time, on budget, as promised, then you have way more control over the profitability of your projects and ultimately over the profitability of your business. So what are some key things in project management that really drive that? And again, you know, if you remember, I said at the beginning, I'm always looking for, and you probably noticed I'm talking about just one or two, maybe three key things in each of these areas that you want to do that allow you to keep your finger on the pulse of the most critical elements that drive profitability in each of those areas. So in project management, it's doing regular schedule updates. Scheduling and managing to a schedule is your key way to being able to see where you're headed before it's history. And the second key place in there is using that information along with your reporting that you got to do cost to complete and to project where am I going to end up at the end of the job. I have found that doing those two things consistently in project management are the number one way to make a consistent profit in your business. I've got a client that when we first started working together, they did not have any cost to complete process in place in their business. And they were, and there was just a very inconsistency, there was a lot of inconsistency in the way the project managers ran the projects and the results that they got, because what they were doing was always chasing after trying to make it happen and trying to, like, looking at just historical information. And I said, what if we did cost to complete? We started looking at where the project is heading. It became this opportunity for the, you know, the project managers once a month that they look up and go, okay, here's everything that's happened, but where am I going to end up? And what they found is that the project managers became much more powerful about the way that they manage their jobs, the way that they manage the client, making sure to capture change orders when change orders were happening that they had not really communicated or that they were on the horizon. Like it just allowed them to get in front of the process rather than chasing after it after the end. So they were more in control over the profitability of their projects and just more in control, period, which had them go from being frantic to being more like grounded and centered about, all right, what's it going to take in order to actually have it work? They had more clarity and they had more confidence and they were able to take more powerful actions. So for you, when it comes to project management, you really want to look at how can you get on a regular schedule for doing schedules for projects and cost to complete on projects. Those two things are going to give you way more control over your project profitability. The last place is where profits are made and lost is every once in a while looking up and even doing this process, look up and go, where am I headed on my project? And what's it, what am I noticing about the projects that I've completed? What kind of projects do I make the most money on? Where am I losing money? What kind of clients are, you know, the ideal clients and the right kind of jobs for us to do and which ones are not? Where are we not being profitable in the work that we're doing that we maybe need to change our estimating? So, and just in general, looking up and going, where can we put in more controls in our business? So that's really what this process is about. And what it will do is it will inform you about what you want to do differently in marketing and what you want to do in terms of estimating, but also where are some changes that you want to make in your business overall. So the question for you is, where do you want to be focusing in this next year in order to start to have more control and more be more intentional about the profitability of your business? So here's my invitation to you is take a look at this, and I'm going to include this in the notes here with the video. And I recommend that you take a look at this for your own business and rate each one of these on a scale of 1 to 5. 1 being I'm not doing it all, 5 being we knock it out of the park, we are exceptional at this. And then based on what you come up with, identify what are the 3 most important places for us to focus in the next 12 months. And then share that with your team. Because this is the way, if you don't do something like this in your business, if you don't stop and choose, then what will happen is the universe will choose for you. And you'll just keep doing what you've done. And you'll keep getting what you've always gotten. And if you be more intentional and you take this action in your business, you're going to find that your profits go up and you're making more consistent profit. And this is also a really great tool to do with your team so that your team and you are all on the same page about where are we headed, what's the most important thing for us to focus on in a business so that we can be more intentional and purposeful about making a consistent profit. So I hope you found today's content helpful. And so one of the things I will invite you to do is check out my book called The Profit Bleed. And in it, I actually give you, you'll have access to a lot of tools and resources that will help you implement a lot of what I've talked about today. And it will really help you implement and get the tools that you need to be able to make those changes in your business. So I wish you all the best as you go forward in making more profits and being more intentional about that in your business. We'll see you next time. I hope you found today's video helpful. If you're ready to take your next step in your leadership journey and to build a great contracting business, I encourage you to check out my book, The Profit Bleed. And for a limited time, you can get my book for free. You simply need to go to theprofitbleed.com/free. Thanks again for joining me for today, and I look forward to seeing you next time on The Profit Builder.